Welcome. You know the drill. When a software problem occurs, you probably head straight to your monitoring dashboards. But too often, other than confirming that there is a problem, you still need to painstakingly hunt through lots of logs to figure out the root cause of the problem. But not anymore. Let's see what happens when you use Zebrium machine learning to do the hard work. In a moment, I'll show you a demo where I'll first install the SockShop online shopping app on a Kubernetes cluster. I've chosen SockShop because it's representative of a typical modern distributed application. It has 13 services and generates over 3 million log lines an hour across 34 log streams. Once it's up and running, I'm then going to break it using a chaos engineering tool and show how Zebrium's machine learning automatically finds the root cause by analyzing the logs. The reason I'm using a chaos tool to break it is because it's a great way to induce a real-world failure scenario. But of course, Zebrium will work equally as well with almost any kind of software failure. For example, here's a sample of the kinds of things Zebrium can detect and root cause: bugs, infrastructure problems, middleware problems, and so on. The reason it works so well across almost any kind of failure is that the machine learning has been modeled on the fundamental ways software behaves when it breaks. In a sense, Zebrium mimics what a really skilled engineer would do when analyzing logs to troubleshoot a new kind of problem. As validation, one of our customers recently performed a detailed study across 192 actual software incidents. Completely unsupervised, the ML correctly detected and found the root cause 95.3% of the time. So, let me now show you a demo. I'll start by creating a Zebrium account and installing the Zebrium log collector on a new Kubernetes cluster in EKS. I do this by copying and pasting this command. Now, I'm going to install the SockShop online shopping app. There we go. Looks like it is working correctly. I've also set up Datadog to monitor this cluster, and this shows that everything looks healthy. I'm now going to install the Litmus open source chaos engineering tool so that a bit later on I can use it to simulate a failure. And since this is a brand new environment, I'm going to let it sit now for about 2 hours. This will give Zebrium's machine learning a chance to learn the patterns in the logs. Welcome back. Just to recap, all I've done so far is installed SockShop and Litmus on a new Kubernetes cluster and let it run for 2 hours with Zebrium collecting the logs. In that time, about 6 million log lines were produced from 34 log streams, which Zebrium has used to get a baseline of this environment. I'm now going to generate a failure by running a chaos experiment that corrupts the network in one of the Kubernetes pods. Here goes. Soon after, you can see the app stops working. Nothing happens when I try to add something to the cart. Looking at the Datadog dashboard, you can also see the network rate and CPU usage have dropped to zero. Now, imagine trying to troubleshoot why this occurred. You would almost certainly need to start hunting through lots of logs. But instead, let's just watch the two Zebrium panels in the Datadog dashboard. This panel contains a word cloud highlighting important words the ML uncovers in the logs. And, in case you're wondering, it's not doing some kind of pre-configured keyword lookup. I'll explain more about how it works later. Look at how a few relevant terms quickly bubble up. Chaos Engine and Sock Chaos just appeared. And now, Pod Network Corruption. Soon after, this panel shows that Zebrium has just generated a root cause report. The title, which was created using NLP, pretty much calls out the root cause. Clicking here takes me to the Zebrium UI, where I will explore the root cause report. This is the NLP summary you saw before, and here is a word cloud that is specific to just this report. You can see that the report is made up of 54 events from 6 different log streams. These 54 events were selected by the machine learning out of the hundreds of thousands of lines that were generated by the app while the chaos experiment was running. On the right-hand side, you can see the actual 54 log events. The column next to the timestamps shows the name of the log that each event came from. The report gives a very accurate account of what happens. The first few lines relate to the chaos experiment being initialized, and then the pod network corruption experiment is actually started. Almost immediately, the kernel detects a misconfiguration on Ethernet port 0, and then you can see how it impacts the application. The carts log shows an exception opening a socket from MongoDB, as well as a connection timeout. Finally, the last few lines of the report show the chaos test ending and cleaning up after itself. Now, it's really important to remember that there were no rules put in place to find these log lines. They were picked out by the machine learning after having only 2 hours of unsupervised learning on the logs. Now that you've seen what the technology can do, let me explain how it works. Essentially, we've uncovered and modeled the fundamental ways software behaves when it breaks. The most important thing to remember is that the machine learning is completely unsupervised. You don't need to create any rules or perform any special configuration for it to work. To start using Zebrium, you simply need to start streaming or uploading your logs, and it achieves accuracy even with very small amounts of data. We use a multi-layered machine learning approach to analyze the logs. It starts as soon as logs are received. The logs can be from any application or type of infrastructure, and you don't have to tell us about the formats or set up any parsing rules. The first layer of the machine learning is the most important. It uses unsupervised machine learning to structure and categorize the log events. Quick side note, it does very well even for new or very rare log events. And this turns out to be important because identifying new and rare events is extremely useful when trying to find the root cause of a problem. Once all the events have been categorized, the next layer of ML learns the patterns for each type of log event. This continues to improve as it sees more data, but even a small number of log lines is enough for it to get a good baseline. Now, as each new event is processed, it is given a score based on how anomalous it is. There are many things that go into anomaly scoring, but the two most significant factors are how rare the event is. For example, an event that occurs for the first time will get a high score, and how bad the event is. That is, events with higher severities get higher scores. Something that is both rare and bad will get an even higher total score. Another side note, even though this type of anomaly scoring is very accurate, the results can still be very noisy, simply because the logs themselves are very noisy. So, the next layer of machine learning takes care of that. It looks for clusters of correlated anomalies across the logs. This is what allows it to find the core events that make up a root cause report. And, in real-life production, we are seeing greater than 90% accuracy in being able to pick out the right log events that explain the root cause. Next, we use GPT-3 to generate a plain language summary of the problem. We also generate the word cloud at this stage. And finally, this is all put together into an interactive root cause report that is available in the UI. Using Zebrium in your own environment has never been easier. Zebrium integrates with almost any kind of CRM, bug tracking, or other application via a comprehensive set of open APIs, as well as many built-in integrations. Now let me quickly summarize what Zebrium is about. Zebrium performs machine learning on logs with the goal of automatically finding the root cause of any kind of software or infrastructure problem. To recap what you saw earlier, when I broke the Sock Shop app, about 500,000 log lines were produced by the application and infrastructure. Our machine learning picked out the right 54 of them that almost perfectly explained what happened. Imagine how long it would have taken a human to piece together the details from 500,000 log lines spanning 34 different log types. The machine learning is unsupervised. This means you don't have to build any rules or perform any kind of manual training to use it. All you do is feed in your app and infrastructure logs, and Zebrium will produce a concise root cause report whenever a problem occurs. Zebrium works with any kind of application and can be used standalone or integrated with your existing monitoring, logging, and incident management tools. To get started, sign up for a free trial at zebrium.com. You can even try Zebrium with the same online web app as used in this video by following the instructions here. Thank you.